Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on the DGS refrigerant leak detector.
Thanks, Keith. Today with the Danfoss DGS detector, we're going to go over the single zone leak detector, which is good for use in machine rooms or walk-ins or any place where you need to constantly monitor the leak PPM. This is available as an IP66 or as an IP41. With the difference being the IP66 can go down to negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit all the way up to 122 degrees Fahrenheit, and it has better protection against water and dust ingress. The IP41 can go down to negative 4 degrees Fahrenheit all the way up to 122 degrees Fahrenheit. These detectors can communicate over Modbus or with an analog output signal that sends the PPM back to a system manager. So when you're communicating over Modbus, you address this with a hexadecimal address, and the baud rate is set by default to 38,400, and that default is true for both this detector and the system manager. If you're going to use the analog output feature, based on the jumper that you select, as you can see in the diagram, you can send a 0 to 5, 1 to 5, 2 to 10, or a 0 to 10 volt signal back to the system manager, or a 4 to 20 milliamp signal back to the system manager to communicate the leak PPM. One thing to consider when placing these on the wall is where you're going to mount it based on your environment. So based on the density of your refrigerant, if it's heavier or lighter than air, and also certain airflows you have like exhaust fans or evaporator fans, you want to consider how your air is going to be mixing and try to get this into a turbulent environment if possible to get the most accurate leak PPM reading. This comes with a built-in 90 decibel alarm, which is used. We also have a relay on this, which requires an external supply, and then it can send 1 amp, 24 volt AC or DC, or 120 VAC out to a relay. So from that relay, you can power things like a horn and strobe, which is useful when you reach your alarm set point. So by default, these come pre-calibrated based on your refrigerant, and the alarm set point by default is 50% of the full scale range, and that is adjustable. Danfoss recommends you do an annual bump test to keep your DGS safe and make sure it's working and keep you safe. Now we'll show you how to wire the DGS leak detector to the system manager. So this is the IP41 version. We also have the IP66 version, which is very similar on the inside, the only difference being the sensor location. So here you have the actual sensor element, and then we have two LED lights which are used. The green one indicates your power, and the red one indicates when you're in an alarm condition. Down here we have the Modbus plug. So you want to make sure that you honor the polarity on the Modbus, that's a requirement. So make sure you match what's on the printed circuit board and you have all your polarity in line there. Here you have the external power supply, which in our case is a 24 volt DC. Here we have the analog output signal, which is sent back to an input board and then sent to the Danfoss system manager. The output signal is configured based on how you have these jumpers set. That'll determine if you have a 0 to 10 or 0 to 5 volt signal coming out. Here we have the two hexadecimal switches, which are used for addressing when you're using the Modbus. And as you can see, we have our external 24 volt supply, and then we have wired to the system manager the actual Modbus. So again, we're honoring polarity there and wiring back to the system manager. And this is the Danfoss DGS leak detector.
To learn more about this topic, check out the description. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.